to searching for that man, but say they've also arrested a supervisor who they say didn't do enough. ABC Action News reporter Heather Lee getting answers tonight from the school.
Body slammed and knocked unconscious. That's what Pinellas Park police say happened to a 12-year-old boy behind the doors of AMI Kids Behavioral School last week.
Here we have a 300-pound man, grown man, with a 12-year-old child that weighs 100 pounds. That has to be taken into consideration anytime you're going to put hands on somebody.
A fractured skull and bleeding in the brain, the result of an argument over skipping the lunch line, according to police. Immediately following the abuse, they say 28-year-old Jarvis West, the supervisor in charge that day, never picked up the phone to call for help.
They waited 2 hours before they put this child on the school bus. What kind of damage occurred to that child? I don't know. I'm not a medical professional. But for 2 hours, this child suffered. And Mr. West did nothing to provide him with medical aid. Nothing.
Instead, police say West got on the bus and rode home with the child, watching him from across the street as he went inside.
Normally, the staff does not ride home with the children.
Police say they are still looking for the staff member that abused the child. West was booked into the Pinellas County Jail and has already bonded out. We tried talking to West at his Pinellas Park home, but no one came to the door.
And everybody's got to be held responsible for their actions no matter what.
Bill Underhill lives next door to West and says he is deeply concerned by the accusations.
He should have called 911. He should have had an ambulance, paramedics there to make sure he was okay. Now it looks like he's going to be facing some serious charges because, you know, he didn't uphold his part of the deal.
Police say the boy should be going home sometime this week and says his mom is still trying to process the entire ordeal. Heather Lee, ABC Action News.
Meanwhile, we reached out to AMI Kids in Pinellas County. They sent a statement saying in part, quote, our thoughts and prayers are with the young man and his family during his time of recovery. They add that disciplinary action was immediately taken and that they do not condone that type of behavior, holding the safety of their students as a top priority.